He's really foolish.
Nobody likes him, you know, because he's make a lot of trouble for the cab drivers.
I really don't care.
Why don't you care?
Because he can do whatever he wants to do. I want to be anonymous. You know, it's up to him whatever he wants to do. Taxis are no big deal. People can walk.
Taxi in New York City when you need one. That's not just my complaint. That's the official finding of every group that has studied the taxi cab industry. The problem begins with the fact that there are in New York City 11,787 medallion taxi cabs. Those are the official taxi cabs which are regulated and inspected by the city, and the number has been frozen for many years. But because of the fact that the number has been frozen, and because of the fact that it is said that these taxi cabs do not go to areas in the city where the poor live, a whole new industry has grown up, the non-medallion industry, which is called the gypsy cab industry. And in addition, there are many executives and large companies which use radio cabs, and that takes some of the medallion cabs off the streets in Midtown Manhattan. In fact, the problems are so complex that the mayor designated a panel of citizens about 2 years ago to study the problem. They came up last year with 73 recommendations. The mayor studied them, agreed with some, disagreed with some, and decided he couldn't do something about some of the others, so he postponed them. We will be discussing those recommendations and the taxi cab industry this morning with Commissioner Jay Turoff, who is chairman of the Taxi and Limousine Commission, with Commissioner Robert Adams, one of the members of the commission, and with a studio audience made up of taxi drivers from all aspects, the medallion industry, the non-medallion industry, radio cabs, and also we'll be including in the audience some people who ride the taxi cabs. We'll be back after these announcements. Commissioner Turoff, as chairman of the Taxi and Limousine Commission, do you expect any changes to take place as a result of the recommendations? And if so, what changes and when will they take place?
Well, the Smith Committee made 73 recommendations in all. And I must say they did a terrific job on the report. And I think they make some very, very good recommendations. In fact, most of them are excellent recommendations that we would look to implement, whether it be completely or partially. But that's the way we're headed. Some of it can be done by regulation. The majority of it has to do with legislation through the City Council and a little bit through Albany. What we have done so far is we have taken a report. We've taken 58 of the key issues that we want to look into and to start to implement and look at.
What's the most important recommendation from your point of view?
Well, I think the green stripe proposal is probably one of the most essential one. In the green stripe proposal, what the Smith Committee recommended was to take delivery vehicles, to regulate them, paint them one color, and have a green stripe on them to signify they are a regulated vehicle, and to allow them to cruise in the outer boroughs, pick up hails in the outer boroughs, have meters north of 96th Street and in the outer boroughs.
Delivery vehicles are the ones that have the L in the license, right?
That's correct.
The medallion cabs are the ones that have the T in the license.
That's correct.
Delivery vehicles are the ones that were called gypsy cabs?
We like to call them car services.
Car service, okay.
They are called gypsy cabs.
Now, in order to bring about this green stripe proposal, do you need legislation or can you do that by regulation?
No, some of it needs legislation. First of all, what the mayor has asked is an environmental impact study be done to see what the effect would be on traffic patterns and pollution if this was allowed to be done and picking up hails in the street by these car services or non-Medallion cars.
They're doing it now.
Yeah, but there's going to be a different type of impact, we feel. We can, by regulation, the commission can authorize meters in these cars. They can authorize various regulations. The part about picking up hails in the street has to change the present regulation by the city council.
So the change in law is the city council, not the state legislature?
No, the city council.
Okay. Commissioner Adams, why was it decided not to increase the Medallion taxi cabs?
Well,
number of Medallions.
The Smith Committee felt that the increase of the number of Medallions really would not increase the service to that much more than congesting Midtown itself. Yeah.
But isn't this setting up a two-level kind of taxi system, having the green stripe and the regular Medallions?
Well, that was really set up in 1971 in the local law 12. That's what came about from that local law in 1971. It's now estimated that there's different estimates, from anywhere from 20 to 40,000 livery vehicles in the city. What the correct number is, even the Motor Vehicle Bureau doesn't know. But they do serve the areas where a lot of the Medallion cabs are reluctant to serve in numbers. They do go to some of these areas, but in droves they don't.
Do you think the city council is going to act soon? And if so, about when? And do you think the bill will pass?
The first part, I think that everybody's just waiting for the environmental impact study to come back, which I think will take probably in the neighborhood of 4 to 6 months to complete. Whether or not it will pass the council, I really don't know. It's a very politically hot issue as far as the council is
concerned. Are you supporting it? And is the mayor supporting it?
The mayor supports the green stripe proposal. The commission would have to vote. We are 9 members on the commission. We have not discussed it as a body as yet.
Do you personally
My position is supporting the mayor's position.
Do you support it, Commissioner?
Well, I definitely support the green stripe issue, yes. Not completely as the Smith Committee recommended it, but there's a very big need for that.
Well, what about service to the public? I mean, do you think that any of this will result in people being able to get a cab faster than they're able to get it now, for example?
Well, I think what it will do, as far as the outer boroughs and the livery vehicles are concerned, and our main concern is that every livery vehicle and every person that goes into that livery vehicle should go into a safe vehicle that has been inspected, that is fully insured, and the driver has had a background check. And I think that that's what it will accomplish.
That isn't being done now?
No, it's not.
No. What about rates? Does the delivery people charge the same as the regular Medallion?
Under the Smith proposal, or the Green Stripe proposal, as we call it, they would be charging the same rates as the Yellow Medallion cab. Right now, when a person calls a livery vehicle, they normally tell them how much it costs for the trip over the phone. It could vary, and in most cases, the person that gets in doesn't really know how much the trip is going to cost. Here, they will know.
Well, can they charge less? Because I've been in some livery vehicles, and they charge less.
The way that the Smith Committee report recommends is that there would be a uniform fare by all.
Because they could not charge less.
No, not under the Smith Committee recommendation. But that doesn't mean that the commission would go along with that. I know there are some commissioners that feel that they should be able to charge less.
And, how do you feel, Commissioner?
Well, I feel that there should be a difference in the rate charged, whether it's more or less.
Well, which one should be higher and which lower?
I feel the Yellow Medallion rate should be higher. Mm-hmm. And I think that the problem, though, is, and I ride the livery cabs in my area quite a number of times, and from one point to the last stop and taking a vehicle, say, every day, you arrive at a different fare for each car every day. It's ridiculous that some meters are less than what the Medallions charge, and some are far more. You know, there's no regulation on them. Whereas in the Yellow Medallion industry, all the meters are
standard.
They're set meters. Yeah.
Well, what about the radio cars? They charge more, don't they?
Not on the meter.
Are you talking about the Medallion radio cars?
No. When you call from the office and you have an agreement with a radio car.
You're talking about a Medallion, Yellow Medallion
radio car. Yes, yes.
If you have a charge account with them, then there is a service charge, usually $3 or $3.50, which is charged for the privilege of billing, which they bill once a month to you. So they do charge more. There is a premium That is charged on the
amount of meter. It's $3.50 per ride, no?
Right, per trip.
So that's a substantial charge.
That's correct.
So there's no likelihood then that even if the regulations are approved, that there would be a uniform rate throughout, because there will always be some discrepancies depending upon whether you use a radio car or a medallion car or a livery, right?
Well, technically, the average person that would take it, whether it be a yellow medallion cab or a livery vehicle, would be paying the same fare. The only one that would be paying a premium would be the corporation or the charge account customer that uses this as a service to be billed instead of paying cash immediately.
Okay, but if all of this is approved, there still will be no increase in the number of medallion or non-medallion taxicabs in Midtown Manhattan. Is that so?
That's correct. There will be no increase in the number of medallions. The medallion figure will stay the same.
Or in number of cabs, because the livery
That's
cabs
right.
will not be allowed to come into Midtown Manhattan.
That's right. They'll be allowed to come in and drop off, but they will not
so
be
then
able
how will the
to
public,
pick up.
How will the public benefit, the average individual who really is not so much concerned about whether it's medallion or non-medallion, but who simply wants to get into a taxi cab quickly in Midtown Manhattan? Will there be any change there?
I think the only thing that we will see in Midtown Manhattan will be the same type of system, the same number of cabs we now have. However, I think we will see an increase in livery vehicles coming into Manhattan to drop off fares, which normally now, whatever percentage of yellows are working the outer boroughs will be working.
But they will not be able to pick up fares?
No, they will not.
Okay.
There's also a proposal that's been made that to not let the yellow radio cars, cabs, pick up during a certain hour of the day, during, say, like from 4 to 6:30 or 5 to 7. So that's freeing these radio cabs for service to the Midtown area.
Okay, we will be back after these announcements.
It's supposed to be work in the city, you know? That's why it's not so good. They charge more than the cab drivers, because their meters is not so good. They just show up on the door, it's 85 cents, but it's a lot more.
I think they should stay up in their own neighborhood.
They work in the city and they take off for us job. They're not supposed to be, they don't pay taxes like we pay.
They have to make a living too. They don't bother us. Listen, there's enough room for everybody out there.
I don't know much about them. I just started out on this job.
The medallion cab, I think they do his job very well, because especially the black, the white people don't take the yellow, the gypsy cab.
Some of them, they don't like to pick up some people in the street, you know. One day told him, uptown, forget about it. Downtown, all the way downtown, forget about it.
You know that the medallion cabs don't like you.
I know you don't like it, but I don't care. Why don't take no people downtown? You know you don't like it, no. Yes, it don't matter. The yellow car, I don't like it, no, the GC car, no.
This morning, we are discussing the problems of the taxi cab industry with Commissioner Jay Turoff, Chairman of the Taxi and Limousine Commission, and with Commissioner Robert Adams, a member of the commission. Would you go ahead with the first question?
I'm tired of hearing that you can't get a cab when you want one. I can't get a ticket for tomorrow night's show. I can't visit a doctor unless I make a 3-week appointment. I can't get a bed in a hospital. This is ridiculous already. How many cabs you want waiting for you? Now, you talk about a green strike cab, which I am against, simply because...
Excuse me, sir. Who are you with now?
My name is Solly Reese. I'm the general manager of United Taxi Owners Guild. That's the medallion owners group. I'm also against the green stripe cab because there won't be any enforcement. There is too many guys cruising down the streets and getting away with it. If they want to stay in their outer boroughs, I have no objections. They're right. They need some coverage up there. Now, also, I don't like the idea of the harassment that's going on by the limousine commissioner, taxi limousine commissioner? Because they're afraid to enforce their non-medallion cabs. They go after us. If you're going to put on more guys
Excuse me, what harassment is being now pursued against you?
There are too many inspectors in the street on minor infractions. That's what I'm against.
All right, Commissioner, do you want to answer that charge?
Well, we have approximately 15 to 20 inspectors on the street at any given time who are monitoring the yellow medallion taxis and do give summonses where infractions are found or where violations of the rules are found. Like anything else, a taxi driver or a regular driver is not happy getting a summons. But if there's a violation of the rules and our people are there, they will step in and take care of it.
Right. Yes, go ahead.
Commissioner, you said that you're not intending to increase the medallion in Manhattan.
Would you identify which...
Yeah, my name is Freddie Perez. I'm from the Non-Medallion Cab Driver Association.
Non-medallion?
Non-medallion.
Okay, go ahead.
You said that you're not intending to increase the medallion in Manhattan right now. But what happened way back 2 years when they increased, and the other way when they put more in 2000 limousine, so-called calling limousine, the way that I see limousine is a big black car, and now what they're using is cruising in Manhattan back and forth. A sedan, four-door, belonged to Bob Hope and Fugazi. Now, we've been waiting for the last 20 years to be in the picture. Now we got to be restricted from 96 up. We cannot cruise in the airport. We got a lot of things. They're talking about putting 200 more inspectors. We know that they're going to send it to the South Bronx or to Brooklyn. Now, what's going to happen with that?
If the green stripe proposal goes through, the whole key to the proposal is enforcement. There has to be enforcement or the program can't work. We anticipate to have about 60 additional inspectors to work strictly on non-medallion and livery vehicles as far as registration is concerned and as far as out-of-borough work is concerned.
Yes, sir.
I'm Kenny Arthur from Affiliated Livery Drivers and Owners of Brooklyn. The majority of people live in the outgoing areas of New York, such as Brooklyn, the Bronx, and Upper Manhattan. The business district is downtown New York. How are you going to set up things for people that are going to these areas coming out of your airports, your Port Authority bus terminals, your Penn Station? How are they going to get cabs? Because most of the cabs don't want to go to these areas. They refuse these people in these areas. What are you going to do to enforce that and set that up?
Well, you want to take that?
Well, yeah, I'd like to answer that for you, Mr. Arthur. And this is one of the inadequacies of the Smith report, in that they came up with the green stripe idea, but the people that work in Midtown, as you say, there's nothing provided for them. In setting up, I've just been appointed as chairman of the Green Stripe Advisory Panel of our commission. It's been put in my lap to tie this Green Stripe program together. And within the next couple of months, I'll be talking with a number of you guys in the non-medallion industry with the groups and the cars. This is a thing that we will have to work on and get together your recommendations we can take to the city council. Like, we have to, in order to be picking up hails on the street, that, as Commissioner Torres said earlier, would have to be changed by the city council, changing local law 12. So these are things that we will have to be working on now.
Well, Commissioner, you seem to have picked the most unenviable job of all, because so far it appears that nobody's in favor of the green stripe provision. The medallion owners say that they're against it, and the non-medallion cab people say that they're against it because they're not allowed to go in the high-income parts of the city.
Well, the medallion owners are concerned about this program for Midtown. They feel it's going to take away money from their Midtown operation. But I've been on this commission since 1975, and I've been fighting through up to now here 1983 to have fairness done in this city for people who want to ride taxi cabs. And the medallion people, if they remember, we had a program going once before trying to regulate the non-medallion industry under the McCall bill back in 1976 and 77, which the medallion owners fought vigorously in the state assembly.
Was that defeated?
It was defeated because they didn't want they said they would legitimize gypsy cabs.
Yes. Go ahead, sir.
My name is Stanley Bacalar. I'm the general manager and president of Ding-a-ling Two-Way Radio Taxi Cab.
Is that a medallion fleet?
It's a yellow medallion fleet, strictly yellow medallion legal fleet. I have had a hack license since 1947 when I started to drive a taxi cab. From 1947 until, I'd say, the middle 50s or early 50s, you could always find me in Harlem, Bedford-Stuyvesant, because it was a safe place to work. I think that last year there were 19 or 20 taxi drivers killed and robbed and killed, and of the 19 or 20, I think 19 happened in bad areas. A taxi driver's concern when he goes out to drive his cab is to make money. Everybody's money is the same color in this town. And we'll make the money when we can, but we don't want to go into areas where it might be unsafe.
So then...
Because their money is as good and as green as anybody else's money. The more it's fear that drives a taxi driver away from a bad area, not the fact that he doesn't want to ride those people, because those people are as good or as bad as any of us.
So tell me, do you support the idea of the green stripe
proposal? I am totally 100% against the green stripe cab. We had the same situation back in 1971 or 72 when we had the Intro 730 introduced by Commissioner Mike, whatever his name was. And
why are you against the proposal?
The proposal is totally inadequate to the yellow medallion taxi driver who has a huge investment in his medallion, which is sanctioned by the taxi commission, which is approved by the taxi commission, by the city of New York, and these people are in business. Each one of us has to go through a very strict procedure before we can get a hack license or before we can own a medallion. It was pointed out in statistics when two-way radio started about in 1960, the outer boroughs are being serviced a whole lot better than they had ever been serviced before because of the advent of two-way radio.
Commissioner,
neither two-way radio nor medallion taxi owners are not against.
Excuse me, this is not a public hearing, okay? Let me ask a question because we have to establish an important point. A lot of people who are watching don't know, and that is you talked about money. How much is a taxi medallion worth, Commissioner, today?
An independent medallion today is worth about $60,000 to $62,000. A fleet medallion is worth about $56,000.
So we really are talking about a valuable property, right? Isn't that what really it comes down to?
That's
between
correct.
The medallion
Absolutely.
And the non-medallion. And if you issue another 30,000 or 40,000 medallions, the value of that 60,000 or 70,000 would be diluted. Isn't that so?
Oh, absolutely. There's no doubt about that. But that's not the question.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's an important part of the underlying discussion that there's money involved in the value of medallions. Isn't that so?
I think you also have to understand that of the 11,787 cabs that are on the street that are either privately owned or fleet owned, there are mortgages of some $500 to $600 million that are in banks against these medallions. People have their whole life savings tied up and their livelihood tied up in it. There's no doubt about that.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Would you identify yourself?
My name is Apollinar Trinidad. I am a liberal taxi owner. I would like to ask several questions in regard to this issue.
Yes, Senator.
My first question is, will you please give to me the number of blacks and Latinos that own yellow cabs or the cabs with medallion? That's the first one.
So wait a minute, let's see. Do you know that, or is that not available?
I don't have that figure. All I can tell you is that approximately 63% of the driver's licenses that we issue through the Taxi and Limousine Commission, we issue some 35,000 a year, are to minorities, whether they be
about
black,
the ownership,
Latino,
the ownership,
Russian.
Not the license. Anybody can drive a taxi. I mean, the ownership.
The medallion ownership.
The
right.
medallion.
Do you have any figures in that?
No, I really don't have those
okay.
figures.
Okay, go ahead with the next question.
Apparently, what's happening here, there's a monopoly. It's a monopoly by the city, and the people that owns the yellow cab or the cab called with the medallion in regard to letting the minority come in into the tax industry. By the fact that it costs money, and there are people from the minority sector, blacks and Latino, that want to come into this industry to give a better service to the city of New York. And this white monopoly is preventing the blacks and Latinos to come into it, because according to this Smith Commission that was designated by Major Cash, the commission found it that you cannot find a cab in the city when you need it. And there is a group or two groups in the city that are willing to invest the money and to come and provide a better service to the city of New York, which all residents of New York City deserve to have a good cab service. And yet, this monopoly is preventing these people, first, to get into business, and second, to provide a good service to the city of New York.
How do you answer the monopoly charge, Commissioner?
The fact of the matter is that the Yellow Medallion is a monopoly.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. It is a set number, and it is to be operated for the public good and public service with a set of rules and regulations. That's how it was established in 1935 under the Haas Act, and that's how it's carried through today. The man is correct. The Medallion is a monopoly. As far as service is concerned and the Green Stripes, the Green Stripe proposal is to give better service to the outlying boroughs and to give safe service to the outlying boroughs, and that's what we would like to see.
Okay, yes, sir, go ahead.
Yeah, I'd like to direct a question to Mr.
First of all, would you say who you are?
Yeah, my name is Abby Legaspi. I'm an independent taxi driver with Dingaling Taxi. From what you just explained, am I to understand that what you're saying is the taxi, the yellow taxi industry now is a monopoly that is anti-black and anti-Latino, as this gentleman stated?
No, I didn't say that. No way do I mean that. Not at all.
Mr. Chairman, if I might, the man asked you a question about percentages or people that own the Latins and black people that own medallion cabs. Now, I don't know about the rest of the city. I know that Dingaling Taxi has 162, and I know that at least one-third of those are owned by Latin and black people.
Medallions.
Yes, sir, medallions. Yellow taxi medallions. The guy who wants to go out there and work, honest, and sweat, he can own it. When I bought my medallion, I didn't have two quarters to rub together, but I worked my fanny off until I paid for it, and that's how everybody else can do it.
Okay, next question. Go ahead.
My name is Jose Rivera. I'm presently a state assembly for the state of New York, but before that, I was a cab driver and also a construction worker.
What kind of cab driver were you?
Non-medallion cab driver.
Okay.
Commissioner Adam, you did talk about a figure of roughly 40,000. Commissioner Turoff, you did mention legislation both from the city and also from the state. Commissioner Turoff, in case you did not know, recently before the assembly, the committee up there in transportation, there was a bill that is not going to come out of committee because it seems to be like a continuation of a repressive type of legislation. But Commissioner Adam, question. What is your position in regard to first of all, I would like to say that the Green Stripe recommendation is one leading in the right direction, if I may say so. It's a recommendation that was made years ago by Kenny Arthur, myself, and Freddie Perez back in 75 when we made up, we were part of an advisory committee to that administration at that time. You do not have an advisory committee at the present. Mr. Adams, what is your position? Because the decision that you gentlemen are making is really going to affect thousands of people, thousands of working people. Are you making it, what are you doing to make each and every one of the families, the individual drivers, aware of your particular suggestions? And are you aware, sir, and do you support the fact that if the regulation are accepted, that you yourself will lose your commissionership, Mr. Adam? Are you for that?
Well, you're asking a two-part question there. And first of all, I don't believe that the recommendation that the 9-member commission be done away with will really go through the city council. I don't believe that will happen. I have my reasons to. If you want me to, I'll tell you what those reasons are. The other thing about the Green Stripe car, and you're right, because I chaired that non-medallion committee, if Mr. Arthur will remember, back in 1975, and we ran into problems with the, as I said, with the McCall bill, which was supposed to be a start of that regulation of that industry. The reason that I'm for the green stripe is Mr. Badillo said it seems like I'm the only one for it. It doesn't, as far as I'm concerned, it doesn't have to be a green stripe car. It doesn't have to be a red stripe. There has to be some regulation of the livery industry to give the people who ride these livery vehicles the safety and experience of getting where they want to go, to have them available, to have the drivers be protected, and to regulate it just the way the yellow medallion industry is regulated. And if you want to call it green stripe or blue or whatever, then there must be regulation.
Yes, sir.
Okay, commissioners, I'm Harrison Young. I happen to be a taxi rider, not a driver. So I'm very concerned about, okay, I've noticed you're talking about the public good, and yet you say you support the mayor. Well, we both know what the mayor's personal interests are, and what his public good does not mean the outlying borough. I happen to live in the South Bronx. So I know that I cannot get a medallion cab or anything coming from Midtown Manhattan, where I happen to work, that'll take me home. So I'd like to know, well, what is the problem here? Now, you talk about environmental impact studies and green striping the cars. Basically, what we want is reliable taxi service to take us home from Midtown Manhattan to the outlying boroughs. Why can't we have that? Why are these delaying tactics? They seem to be stalling tactics to me. So I'd like to know, what is the makeup of the commissioners? Do they all live in Midtown Manhattan, or do they live in the South Bronx or Brooklyn or even Upper Manhattan, to say the least?
Well, let me answer that, and I think Mr. Turoff gave the big answer to that when he first started speaking. That, in this taxi industry, is the hottest political issue that is there. It is really a hot political issue. And the lead off with it is giving the drivers the right to pick up hails on the street. That is the hottest political issue, which will be the biggest part of the fight. I have my ideas about it. Some of the people in the yellow medallion industry have their ideas. Some councilmen have
What are your ideas about it?
Well, my ideas are that I feel they should have the right to pick up hails.
To pick up in Manhattan, as the gentleman said, and take them to the South Bronx?
That's right.
Even if they're not medallions, is that right?
That's right.
Okay.
And even if you limit it to certain hours of the day, if you want to do it that way.
Now, Commissioner Turoff, how do you feel about that point of view? Do you agree with him or disagree with him?
I want to make one point about the makeup of the commission, because I think that's important. It was an important question that he asked. The makeup of the commission presently, there's 9 members, 5 of which are appointed by the city council, 1 from each borough. The other 4 are appointed by the mayor. Of the 4 mayoral positions, 2 are Manhattan residents, 1 of which happens to be Mr. Adams, and the other 2 are people that live in the outer boroughs.
Okay. Now, what about your point of view on the non-medallion cabs picking up people in Midtown Manhattan and taking them to Brooklyn, Queens, or the Bronx?
By prearrangement only. In other words, the way the plan calls for it would be that if somebody calls up from mid-Manhattan and says he wants to take a livery vehicle and be picked up at his office to go to the South Bronx, there's no problem with that car coming in and picking him up. But to come in to cruise the streets of Manhattan, he cannot do, and I'm against cruising the streets of Manhattan.
We will be back after these announcements.
Have you ever been robbed?
I never was robbed, but somebody else was robbed.
Almost. There's a lot of bad people out there. It's a terrible world.
How'd you get out of it?
God saved me.
I took a passenger from bus terminal to Brooklyn, and I was stopping on the red light on Eastern Parkway, and 5 guys came from both sides. They took me out of the car. They took my passenger out of the car. They beat me and beat the passengers. They scratched front window on the car. They took all my money, and they took the purse from the woman. As a matter of fact, it was a pregnant woman. They beat her too. And after they finished, I took the woman to the police, and after they sent her to a hospital.
And despite that, you continue to drive?
Yes.
Why?
Because it's my job. The crime is always the crime, but we gotta do our jobs.
This morning, we're discussing the problems of the taxicab industry with Commissioner Jay Turoff and Commissioner Robert Adams. Would you go ahead with the next question?
Yes, sir. My name is Pablo Alvarez. I'm a private owner. I just own about three or four taxis. And I got a question because I'm sick and tired. I drive 28 years in New York City. I got my hack license in 1954, in August 6, 1954. I'm sick and tired already, heard about we can get a taxi. Now, I started driving last night, 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm working straight to 11 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm booking $77. And I got 143 mileage. Now, I got my two taxis right now in the garage just because the hack inspector put me over on 42nd Street by 11:45. He say I'm in suspension lease, and I never get the letter. He sent the letter to Queens, and I never got it myself. Now, my two cars is in the garage. My two drive is not working now just because the hack inspector put in my trip car away for me. Now, from 6 o'clock in the morning to 7:45, I just came from 200 Street on Broadway. I came all the way to 14th Street, cruising west side, east side, and I never picked up a call. So, then I sit for another 20 minutes in the world of Astoria.
So what is your question?
Please. My question is we don't need no more taxi because we drive it 2-3 hours, we can pick it up by call. After 8 o'clock, we don't got it. We don't got people in the right. street.
How do you answer that? I'm talking now about after 8 o'clock in the evening.
All right. We had a problem with evening hours as far as the theater district was concerned. Between the hours of 8 and 11 in the evening, there was a problem with service. To try and give an incentive for the drivers to stay out more, we had a 50-cent nighttime differential. We have found that lately, whether it's due to the economy or whatever, we find there are more cabs out in the evening hours than there have been before. But there are certain times during the day, as if anywhere, that there are cabs available, and that there are certain times that are peak hours where just not enough. If you had 30,000 in mid-Manhattan, there just won't be enough cabs.
Okay. Yes, sir, go ahead.
Commissioner Adams, you say you're for the green stripe. The thing is, if they do pass legislation for the green stripe, where are you going to put them? As it is now, I don't know if Commissioner Turoff or former Deputy Mayor Badillo has been traveling in Midtown. There is no room, there's no hack stands. It's very difficult for the two-way radio and the regular cabs to get parked anyplace. It takes time. We're losing too much time in traffic to move around. This is why it's very difficult to get service. If you're going to permit green stripes to come in, where are they all going to go? Where are they going to move to? We're jammed in traffic now.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, let me say this to you. One thing I find, and a lot of people drive their private cars into Midtown because they cannot get taxis to take them back to their areas. And they're scared of riding subways. They're scared of getting on a bus. So there are a lot of cars in Midtown, too, that are causing the jam up. It's not all taxis.
Okay. Yes, sir.
My name is Richard Niclerio. I'm the president of Skyline Radio Taxi Association. It's a medallion association. You made a statement before that there's the possibility of not allowing radio cabs to pick up between the hours of 4 and 7. The radio cab services the public 24 hours a day, going to all different parts of the city. And it's the public that we service. The idea that you said is to service the public better. We will not be allowed to pick up between 4 and 7. Where does it change that these people that call us are not the public between 4 and 7?
Well, the reason of this recommendation by the Smith Committee is because of that hour between 4 and 6:30 is an hour that was a span of time that's picked where there's a big demand for cabs. And it has been known that there are cabs sitting in front of big office buildings with their radio signs on waiting, and they have calls where they could be cruising the streets picking up people that need the cabs.
The question I asked is, why aren't these people that call us between 4 and 7, why do you not consider them the public between those hours? We are servicing the public, but you're saying between 4 and 7, we cannot service the public who call. What is the difference between the public that calls and the people that call us? Are people that are taken to the outlying areas, into bad areas, because they want the availability of a cab, which we give them, The question I asked is,
right,
how do you determine that they're not the public anymore between 4 and 7? You haven't answered that
well,
yet.
Well, you're saying to me that I should tell you why they're not the public. I believe they're still out of public. But what you must understand, at this moment, right now, the only cab that is legally and lawfully able to pick up a hail on the street is a yellow medallion. You are, as I said before, a monopoly. That is your purpose. The radio comes second, as far as I think of it. And if you're not out there picking up these people who want to be hailed, then you know maybe you should take radios out of your car.
Okay. All right. Yes, sir.
Crespo Salvador. I drive a private car, which you call the gypsy cab. And for some reason, someone is always saying that we're ripping off the public, such as you said, that our meters are much too fast.
Well, no, you misunderstood what I said.
But you
some
yourself...
meters, I said some meters are fast, some are slow, some don't have meters at all.
But
now,
you...
wait just a minute. If I take a ride that encompasses, say, 15 to 20 blocks, and you have a meter in your car that you put on the door, it's calibrated 85 cents on the first drop and 10 cents per ninth of a mile, I should expect to pay what's on that door and not get those 20 blocks later and be asked for $5 when that's not a $5
prior
ride.
Prior to that, you say you take a cab 5 times and each time your rate is different on every cab. Now, in our industry, if we take a passenger, they all know what the fare is. If it's $2 and the meter reads 3, they're going to pay you 2.
Yeah, but then if you have a man in a cab.
But you are saying that what is being suggested is that the meter is fast. I mean, it may show $2 or $3, but that it goes faster than it should. Have you found that to be a case? Do you agree with that?
I'm just what he said was a deliberate attack on us. He's saying that we are a bunch of ripoff artists. That's what he implied at the beginning.
I didn't imply ripoff. I'm trying to tell you what is wrong with not having a regulated, calibrated meter for all cabs. I'm not saying this the industry is ripping people off, but you will find in everywhere you go that somebody just wants to do something dishonest. And I'm not saying that that's the majority.
Don't you believe that every yellow cab it's all the same rates? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
That's correct. That's right.
That's virtually impossible. 10,000 cabs.
Those meters are calibrated by licensed meter shops.
How do you do that with a private owner if he wishes to change it?
The same way. It's the same way. If you have a meter in your cab, it should be calibrated by a licensed meter shop, inspected and licensed by our commission.
Okay, go ahead, Commissioner. Yes.
Number one, livery vehicles by law are not supposed to have meters in their car. Only yellow medallion cabs are supposed to. What we're trying to do under this system, if it comes through and meters are allowed in livery vehicles, is to have a uniform fare where everybody that gets in knows exactly what they would be paying and what the fare would be. And as far as if this goes by the meter instead of a flat rate, then those meters would be tested at least once a year, as all yellow medallion meters are tested now and certified by licensed shops.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'd like to, my name's Abby Legaspi with Dingling Taxi. I'd like again to address my question to Mr. Turoff. Mr. Turoff, I understand now that there's a problem with the amount of inspectors that the TLC has on the street now enforcing the medallion industry. If the TLC proposes, or the Smith Commission proposed, to add another 30 or 40, I think you said, to bring a total of 60, and then the green car thing is introduced, which would bring, I don't know how many gypsy cabs are back on the streets. How do you propose to enforce the industry at that time and to keep the gypsy cabs above 96th Street?
Well, there's a few things we're going to have to do. And I said before, earlier in the program, that enforcement is the key. And we're talking about 60 additional inspectors that would be earmarked specifically for the livery end of the business. What we intend to do as well, as part of tightening up the program, is issuing a different type of plate other than the livery plate that's now used. That the Motor Vehicle Bureau will issue a special livery plate that would be only used by New York City liveries, the five boroughs. We will also be, no plates will be issued unless proof of insurance and certification is given first by the Taxi Limousine Commission. These are all enforcement tools that we're using. As far as street enforcement is concerned, I agree with you. It's a major problem. But I think that it would, with more inspectors on the street, and I think with a comprehensive program with what we want to do overall, it can work. I think, unfortunately, what we've done here this morning is the Smith Committee report. We've only spoke about one of their 73 recommendations. And I guess it's the an important recommendation, but everything else in the report also impacts on this and tightens up this program.
Well, Commissioner, you pointed out that a previous recommendation, after long discussion, had been defeated. In view of what you heard here this morning, do you think that this recommendation, just this one recommendation, can be approved?
You're talking about the Green Stripe proposal by the City Council?
Yes.
I personally believe that it can be approved. Whether or not it will, I really don't know. It's hard to tell until it comes before, until the legislation is written, it comes before the council. I think there's a lot of support for that. I think that in the informal meetings we had with the Transportation Committee, I think it's a very controversial issue, but there is a lot of grassroots support among city councilmen.
Yes, go ahead.
Hi, my name is Irene Galanta, and I'm a native of the Bronx, an ex-dispatcher for the non-medallion taxi drivers, and recently I'm a passenger. I'm here this afternoon for moral support, let's say. My question is, I have been behind the scenes working with the taxi, with the non-medallion drivers, and I've seen all the harassment they've been subjected to in the last 10 years since I've been with them. As a dispatcher and as a passenger now, I want to ask you, why the pause between decisions? What is the delay? Does the public have anything to say about this? Do we, the passengers, have anything to say? What is the delay behind these decisions that you're trying to make?
Okay. First of all, before any law would be enacted, there would be a public hearing on it where all interested parties would be asked to come down and testify and give their opinion. Right now, there are two things happening. First, legislation is being written to go before the City Council to implement this, and secondly, an environmental impact study is being done. It's being done at the same time, and I'm sure the City Council will be calling public hearings shortly to get the public view.
Yes, yes, sir, go ahead.
My name is Armando Zio, and I'm a livery driver. My question is, like, if the Green Stripe gets approved, how do you go about it, and what is it going to cost us?
What is it going to cost?
Yeah.
Well, the registration fees now for any for-hire vehicle in the City of New York is $150 for the registration fee to the Taxi and Limousine Commission. There's a $100 commercial use tax fee, which goes to the Department of Finance, and a driver's license fee, which is $15 per year. So the total is $215 per vehicle. $265 per vehicle.
Now, there's also a problem, Commissioner, between the medallion taxi owners and the union. What is the nature of that problem?
Presently, right now?
Yes.
Well, their collective bargaining agreement has run out, and they are in negotiations for a new contract. And they're tied up on two points, from what I understand. One is major medical and health benefits, and the other is leasing. The fleet owners want to have a right to have 100% leasing, and for new drivers who are strictly commissioned drivers to be able to lease a cab if they want to. And the union wants to have a certain percentage for only commission and a certain percentage for leasing.
One last question. Go ahead.
Yes. On the Green Stripe cab, I don't know how many have in mind to approve, whether it be 1,000 or 5,000. What happens to ones that aren't Green Stripes? They're going to come down the city if the Green Stripe cabs are approved. What's the impact then?
Well, very simply, whatever cars meet the requirements and register will be registered. Those cars that are for hire vehicles that are not registered, then we will take action against it. We have a bill in the New York State legislature now which would empower us to turn tickets into judgments, TLC tickets into judgments, and to move against the vehicles. I mean, there are a number of things I said before that this report closes in on.
We will be back after these announcements. is clear that the problems of the taxicab industry are not easy to resolve. There were 73 recommendations in the report that was made to the mayor, and this hour we've only been discussing one of those. And therefore, it's going to be a long time before any of those are implemented. But if we were not able to move the traffic along, at least I hope that we were able to move the discussion along. I want to thank Commissioner Turoff and Commissioner Adams for being here this morning. I want to thank all of you as well.
Thank you.